I'm talking about Jesus, the one that rose from the dead. Jesus, Alpha and Omega. Jesus, he is the answer. Jesus, he's here. He has risen. He has risen. He has risen. He has risen. Ooh, oh, he is the answer. Jesus is, he is. He is the answer. He has risen from the dead. Yeah, he took the stain out of death. Ooh, he took the stain out of death. Ooh, he is the answer to your problems. I know that I know that I know that I know. I know Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. A few, yeah. But he is the answer,
Jesus, the answer.
To all of your problems.
You need.
Yeah.
Jesus is the answer.
Jesus is.
Yeah.
Jesus is.
Jesus is the answer.
He is the answer.
Everything you need.
He is the
Jesus
answer.
Is the answer.
I know that I know that I know that I know.
Jesus is the answer.
He is the answer.
Yeah.
Holy Ghost hands together. Hey! Ah! Glory! the drummer and the taste of the living God. Ready? One, two. Chapter starting at the fifth verse. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, "Fear not ye, for I know that you seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen. As he said, come. See the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you." Heavenly Father, we praise you, we glorify you, and we lift you up, your majesty, your honor. Our Savior, our Keeper, you have risen, and I'm so glad, and I'm asking you to bless us, your people, this day, God. Give us a fresh word. Give us a fresh anointing, a life-changing change of anointing in the mighty name of Jesus. Send help from your sanctuary. God, we come this morning for healing. We come for deliverance, and we come for breakthrough, breakthrough. This Resurrection Sunday morning, we want a breakthrough. We don't want to just leave like we came. We want healing. We want deliverance. We want miracles. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you all the praise and glory. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. away our sins. It's nothing but the blood of Jesus. How many know that it's nothing but the blood of Jesus? His piercing blood that he shed on Calvary's cross. I thank him for the blood. I thank him for the blood. Hallelujah. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood. Jesus.
But the blood.
Hallelujah.
Glory, glory, glory. On behalf of our pastor, Dr. Jeannette Taylor, and Jesus is the Answer Ministries, We would like to welcome our visitors, Facebook family, YouTube family. We like to welcome you on this day, not just today, but every Sunday. And we also like to welcome you on our Bible class on Wednesdays from 7 to 8. We believe in letting Jesus have his way. So if you don't have a church home, look no farther. We welcome you to join here. I'm standing also for our announcements. There will be no Bible class this Wednesday, April the 3rd, 2024. Also, the Midwest to begin Tuesday, April the 2nd, 2024. House of Prayer to All Nations. The address is 5501 North Park Drive, Washington Park, Illinois. They will host the council. Amen. Amen.
He will never lose his power. I know it reaches from the highest mountain, and it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, the blood
that gives me strength
from day. It is offering time. I thank God for offering. We're still making a sacrifice, not only in our worship, but we're sacrificing in our giving. And we praise God, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Will men just give unto your bosom? I'm expecting. I'm watching. I'm waiting on his word. Hallelujah. When I go to my mailbox, I said, okay, let me see. Do I have a check in the mail? I don't have nothing. I said, okay, somebody's not being obedient. Somebody knows that God told him, send Jesus the Answer Ministries a blessing. Yeah, but you're trying to build up your savings. Yeah, I'm telling you. But when you give, God's going to give into you abundance. I hear the sound of rain. Yeah, I hear the sound of rain. I thank God for Mother Simmons being with us today. God is good and greatly to be praised. I add the, you can watch, see, view our screen, the ways of giving, and we just appreciate when you sow, you're sowing on good ground. Heavenly Father, I praise you and I glorify you. I'm expecting for you to do what you said that you're going to do. I hear the sound of abundance of rain. Just overflow. Just let it overflow. Not only monetarily, but overflow in healing, in deliverance. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus. Breakthrough. We praise you. We glorify you and lift you up in Jesus' name. Amen. In the hands of the officers today.
You came, I kept yours.
The shedding of their blood.
Oh, For the Lord, my soul is thirsty. I want the more of God. It just seems like I can't get enough of Him. My soul is thirsty. Jesus, feed me, God. Yes. Isaiah, the 53rd chapter, starting at the 5th verse from the ERV version, the easy read version. But he was being punished for what we did. He was crushed because of our guilt. He took the punishment we deserved. And this brought us peace. Did you see? Did you get that? Say, let this digest. Let this word digest. Yes, this brought peace. Him being crushed because of our guilt. That brought him peace. Oh my God. We were healed because of his pain. Ooh. We had all wandered away like sheep. We had gone our own way. And yet the Lord put all our guilt on him. He was treated badly, but he never protested. He said nothing, like a lamb being led away to be killed. healed. He was like a sheep that makes no sound as its wool is being cut off. He never opened his mouth to defend himself. He was taken away by force and judged unfairly. The people of his time did not even notice that he was killed, but he was put to death for the sins of his people. He had done no wrong to anyone. He had never even told a lie, but he was buried among the wicked. His tomb was with the rich, but the Lord was pleased, yeah, with this humble servant who suffered such pain. And while I'm going through, saints of God, I want the Lord to be pleased with me. Lord, I want to go through my tested trials. I want to go not murmuring and complaining, but I want you to be pleased with me. Even after giving himself an offering for sin, he will see his descendants and enjoy a long life. He will succeed in doing what the Lord wanted. And the last verse, after his sufferings, yeah, he will see the light and he will be satisfied what he experienced. The Lord says, my servant who always does what is right, he will make his people right with me. He will take away their sins. And I like this. I want to focus right there. Yes, and he will satisfy with what he experienced. After your suffering, after you go through, saints of God, yeah, he will. You will be satisfied with what you have gone through, but where God taken you to. And my subject today, the resurrection of Jesus gave peace to the anguished Mary and rescued the world. Not only as Mary was, not only was she anointed to birth Jesus, yeah, she was given supernatural strength to watch Jesus being crucified. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I praise you, I glorify you for your goodness and your mercy and your mighty acts. I ask you in the mighty name of Jesus to feed us until we want no more. Let our cup just overflow. Feed us your word. Speak while your servant listen, and we'll praise you, we'll glorify you and lift you up in the matchless name of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. Yes. Can you imagine the agony of Jesus's mother Mary at the cross? Can you imagine that? Down through the years, I have not heard many Easter sermons focused on the trauma that Mary had to have had to experience. Oh my God, I can't even fathom if one of my sons, oh my God, on the cross and to bear, oh my God, what Jesus bear, I wouldn't be able to stand to watch it. I couldn't even. And if you say, well, I don't have any children, if it was your father, if you say, well, I don't even have, my father didn't raise me, if it was a loved one at the cross, how could you stand there? I'm telling you, saints, I don't. Mary had to have supernatural strength to bear, my God. Yes, it was almost like her, when you know, when her being pierced in the heart, my God, I'm telling you, yes, she had to watch her son beaten and whipped all night long. Oh my God, I think I would have a heart attack. I'd probably just die. I wouldn't be able to watch it. You know, I didn't even birth Jesus. And I can't, when I'm reading about how they treated my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, when I look at the pictures, oh my God, how they depict Jesus, when they whipped him all night long, disfigured. My God, it almost, I began to cry every time. Hallelujah, saints of God. When I see, just watching how they did my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Oh, God, Mary, God gave her a supernatural strength to see how they treated her son. Yeah, when our children are being mistreated or done wrong, or whether it be their job or anywhere else, yes, we feel for them. And sometimes, saints of God, tests and trials that we go through, saints of God, we cannot do absolutely nothing about it. Mary couldn't do nothing. Her hands were tied. She couldn't do nothing about what they were doing to her son. Yes. Yeah. She had to watch them beat and whip all night long with the rope called the cat of nine tails, with metal balls and bones and metal spikes at the end. I couldn't even imagine when they were so angry and they hated Jesus so, when they took the whip, I can just imagine and hear the sounds. When they took the whip and they whipped him, and the Bible said, yes, there's the bones and the metal. You could hear the crunching sound. Yes, when they whipped it and the skin just came off of his body. Yes, yes, here we see Mary had to watch. Yes, when Jesus, they took Jesus to Pilate. Yes, and they scourged him. They flogged and whipped him. And the soldiers, having twisted together a crown of thorns. Oh my God, they took the crown of thorns. My God, and they pounded it on his head. I was looking and researching. It said that the disc went down into the brains and the blood vessels. When they pounded the thorn, the crown of thorn on his head. And yes, they threw a purple cloak around him. Yes, Mary couldn't do absolutely nothing about that. And they kept coming to him and saying, "Hail, King of the Jews, good health to you, peace, you King of the Jews," constantly making fun of Jesus. Mary had to watch and endure that. They struck him with the palms of their hands on his face. Yes, oh my God. Then Pilate went out again and said to them, "Yes, I bring him out to you so that you may know that I find no fault in my Lord, in Jesus, the one that you're trying to persecute. I find no fault." And every time he would say, "I find no fault," they would scream more the louder, "Crucify him." They had no reason. Yes, I can't find no reason why you want to crucify him. Mary couldn't go to him and say, "Oh, yes, he's innocent. Please don't crucify him." Yes. So Jesus came out wearing the thorn crown and purple cloak. And Pilate said to them, "See, here is the man." When the chief priests and attendant guards saw him, they cried out even the more, "Crucify him." Oh, Mary wanted to tell him he's innocent. Oh, my God. But her voice was silent. They wouldn't listen to her as they slowly sagged down with more weight on the nails of the wrist, excruciating fiery pain shoots along the fingers and up the arms to explode in the brain. Oh my God, can we put that photo up? How they were beating our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and Mary couldn't do absolutely nothing. Oh, the soldiers, they repeatedly struck Jesus on the head with a staff, and they arrogantly spat on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Jesus, yes, face had been swollen, his eyes blackened, his nose blackened. money by the abusive Roman soldiers who were anxious to punish an insurrectionist. I come to tell you, Jesus, yes, he didn't say a mumbling word. Mary couldn't say anything to them. My God, Jesus had endured a scourging which nearly killed him. He was bleeding from all over his body following the scourging, the crown of thorns, the nails in his wrists and his feet, and the lacerations following his beating and falls, tied to a pillar. Keep that photo up for me just a little while longer. Tied to a pillar, the soldiers tear into his flesh and lashes up the whip. Yes, only stopping when they were exhausted. They were beating him and whipping him so, yes, they just got exhausted trying to beat my Savior. So they said, okay, I'm tired. Your turn. Beat him some more. But Jesus, through it all, he never said a mumbling word. He could have come down, but he refused to come down because he had me in mind. Over 2,000 years ago, he had Jen in mind. I will not come down from the cross. I got Jen in mind. I have her sons in mind. Jason, Justin, and Jordan. I got Jen's mama in mind. You get where I'm going? He had you in mind. That's why he refused to come down. I refuse. They beat me. Yeah, but I had to go through this. Jesus said, I could when we went before Pilate. Pilate said, oh my God. Pilate said, yes, well, I don't see anything you've done wrong. Who are you? When they said that he said that he was going to raise himself from the dead. Yeah, and this scared Pilate. And so Pilate said, where you come from? What planet did you come from? My God. He said, and so you're going to be silent? Jesus didn't say a word. No. Yeah, so he said, you're going to be silent? Do you know who I am? I can tell. I can stop them from killing you. Yeah, but Jesus said, yeah, no man can take my life. I lay down my life. If I want to, I can call, 12 legions. Yes, if I want to, but I must die for the sin of the world. I must go. This is something that I must do. Yeah, 12 legions. I can call 12 angels from heaven and they can save me, but I refuse to come down. I refuse to come down. I gotta save the world. I got the world on my shoulder. I gotta save him. The goat's blood wouldn't do it. The dove's blood wouldn't do it. It couldn't save him. No. The lamb's blood couldn't save him. The dove, no. I gotta come down. Jesus said, yes, God said, I gotta take myself, wrap myself up in flesh. I gotta come down for my blood to be shed. Yes, God. Mary couldn't do nothing. Yes, only stopping when they were exhausted. We see Jesus as the suffering servant, the man of sorrows, as depicted in the book of Isaiah. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, I am healed. With his stripes, I am delivered. With his stripes, I'm healed of cancer. By his stripes, I'm healed of heart condition. With his stripes, I'm healed of arthritis. With his stripes, I am healed of diabetes. But yes, spasms in the mighty name, back spasms. I'm healed. I'm delivered. At the cross, Jesus took it. At the cross, he bared my sicknesses and diseases and disorders. It was at the cross. At the cross, he healed. That's why it was a must. I lay down my life. You can't take my life. And whatever the enemy tell you, whatever the enemy tell you, saints of God, yeah, he can't do no more to you than what God allow. All power is in the hands of the Lord. bits of lead and stone made the whip brutal, slashing instrument of terror, ripping Jesus' back and legs to shreds. Jesus was led like a sheep to slaughter, and Mary, all Mary could do was stand there and watch her son beaten. According to the Gospel of Mark, he endured the torment of the crucifixion from the third hour between approximately 9 a.m. and noon until his death, the ninth hour corresponding about 3 p.m. Jesus had to walk and he had to carry, yes, the cross about 2,000 feet when forced to carry his own cross. The beams, oh my God, the beams, they rubbed Jesus' shoulders raw. Yes, when he stumbled and fell on the rough streets, his skin, his elbows, and his knees. Oh my God, every breath was a struggle for my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Mary had to look at him. Every breath was a struggle. Every movement produced jarring pain, but Jesus suffered the cruel and inhumane torture of his crucifixion for 6 agonizing hours for us. He did it for us. He did it for me. He did it for me. Jesus did it. He did it for me. When Mary was escorted to the crucifixion, she looked up at the three crosses and asked, which one is he? She couldn't even recognize him. They had to tell him Jesus was in the middle. I come to tell you, when you're in the middle, promise, problem, provision, when you're in the middle, say to God, that's when things get rough. God promised you, I'm going to heal you. God promised you, I'm going to bring you out. But it's in the middle, say to God. It's in the valley. It's in the fire that God is making you. He's strengthening you. Everything going to be all right. Because when you come out of the valley, you're going to be made whole. There is a provision. God's got the provision. He's got it. Shout glory. Shout glory. Yeah, Jesus was bitten. He was beaten beyond recognition. The prophet Isaiah predicted that many would be appalled at him. His appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any man, and his form marred beyond human likeness. Peter wrote that Jesus bore our sins in his body on the tree. His body, yes, were beaten just for me. My God, when the chief priests and the attendants and the guards saw that they cried out, crucify my Lord, they didn't mind it at all. All night long they beat him. Mary wanted to tell them he was innocent. Yeah, yeah, yes. Pilate said to them, take him yourselves, because he didn't find no fault. So he said, I tell you what, you take him. Hallelujah. My God. Yes. It's something when you see a loved one going through a situation. Yes. She also hears the jeering of the crowd, and every cruel word cuts her own heart. But the suffering she endures is not only her maternal reaction. That's my son. You're calling names. That's my son. I know he's innocent. Jesus, the man, I am reminded. You know, when your children are going through, you go through. I am reminded. Yes, the man, yes, he parked in a handicap park at his apartment complex. And he went to the house. house, and the police came, broke into his house, and for no reason, just broke into his house. He said he didn't have any tags, whatever. But you know what? The mother of that son, the family of that son, they were upset, but they couldn't do nothing about the situation. They couldn't stop them from taking him to jail. But I want you to know, saints of God, there are so many things that's going to happen to us, and we can't do nothing about it. But our Heavenly Father, He's with us. Yes, God constantly tells me daily, Jen, I'm in this thing with you. It may look like that you're all alone. Yeah, but you're not alone. Yeah, I'm allowing you to do this. Yes, it's good that you are afflicted, so you can know and see the salvation of the Lord. Yes, her Mary's heart aching as the blaspheming and the hatred they are directing toward their Savior. Yes, her heart aches toward the only begotten Son of God. She understands perhaps more clearly than anyone except Jesus himself who he is and why, yes, he has come. Mary knew why he was come. Mary, the angel said to her, yes, do not be afraid. Yes, that's when the angel came to let her know that she was pregnant. Oh my God, young boy. Yeah, I haven't been with nobody. Yes, but the angel said, do not be afraid. And God told me to tell you this thing that you are going through. Don't be afraid. Yes, sometimes, saints of God, the lions roar. Yes, the demons roar is so loud and it's frightening. But God has his angels with you, and he's saying, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Oh my God, yes, you find favor, my God, when you find favor with God, look to see, saints of God, for the enemy to come in to sow a seed of doubt. Yes, you are happy, you have found favor, you shouting and you praising and you magnifying God, but I come to tell you, oh my God, you're on that mountaintop. Look for Satan to try to steal your joy. But I'm so glad to report the world didn't get it and the world can't take it away. This joy that I have, the world didn't get it and the world sure can't take it away. Oh my God. And the angels told Mary, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. I love to say the name Jesus is so sweet. Jesus, all taste and see. Jesus, when you don't know what else to say, all you have to say is Jesus, and he will come to your rescue. He will catch you before you fall. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. He's the Son of the Living God. He's our day bread. He's Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of the ancestor David. Mary, she is the woman who told the servants at Cana, do whatever he tells you to do. Mary knew the anointing that her son had. She knew. Yeah, she raised him. She birthed him. She knew. Yeah, whatever he tells you to do at that wedding, whatever he tells you to do, do it. Mary, who is the Ark of the New Covenant, whose son was conceived by the Holy Spirit. Mary, who Gabriel called full of grace. She was sinless one. How much must have we hurt her to see her people turn against her? Their God, she was so hurt. An armor roving soldier physically bars the weeping Mary from approaching her son. Yes, she's trying her best. Yes, she wants to comfort him so. But while he's carrying the cross, yes, one commentary said he looked at Mary, yes, and let her know that he's going to be all right, that he's got to go through this. Yes, I'm in pain, but I'm going to be all right, mama. Another commentary said, yes, Jesus didn't look at her. Oh, my God, he kept his eyes on the mission. Yes, God, but whatever Mary, she wanted to get close to her son. Yeah, Jesus carries his cross steadfastly, eyes ahead, focus on his mission to make their separation even more complete. A second soldier stands at Jesus' back, his shield pressed against Jesus. How much must it hurt Mary to be prevented from drawing close to her son, from offering him comfort? How hard it is when we must watch a loved one when they're suffering. I remember my dad, before he passed away, he was in so much pain. I tried to get him sometimes, his mind off of the pain. I was trying to tell him, yes, about his guitar playing, but that still, his pain was so severe, couldn't do nothing about it. But I began to pray. Yes, saints, when you have a loved one going through and you can't do nothing about it, just pray and ask God to heal and deliver. How much, yes, how hard it is to watch a loved one suffering. They may want to just give up. Yeah, they feel effort and worthless. Yeah, they may want. Yeah, surely, Jesus, surely, Jesus, 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 he bare the cross for us. Yes, but surely Jesus was aware of Mary's presence. That's why, saints of God, I believe, yes, it never told when Jesus, when he finally died at the cross. Yes, when he died, it never said, yes, when the women, when they came to put ointment and myrrh, yes, it never said Mary was there. No, but I believe, saints of God, when he rose, he went to Mary first before he went to anybody. Yeah, to comfort her, to let her know everything, everything. I'm risen, mother. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Although at the same time, his heart, yes, must have been breaking to see his dear mother suffering. At noon, the whole country became dark. My God, the darkness continued for 3 hours. About 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out. Yeah, I'm telling you one thing, before he cried out, the moon, yes, and the sun refused to shine at this ugly thing that they were doing to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And the Bible said, about 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out loudly, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani. This means, my God, why have you let me alone? Yeah, yeah, it seemed like you may be all alone, but let me tell you, saints, God is with you. God is with you. He told me to tell you, I'm with you in this thing. When Jesus saw his mother standing there beside the disciple, he loved her. He said, dear woman, here is your son. My God, yeah, yeah, yeah. This disciple that Jesus loved, he told him, take care of my mother. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he said to this disciple, here is your mother. And from then on, this disciple that Jesus loved took her into his home. Jesus knew that his mission was now finished. And to fulfill the scripture, he said, I am thirsty. So when he said, I'm thirsty, they took a sponge, put it on a stick, yeah, with vinegar, yes, and wine, and give it to him. But he said, I am finished. And when he said, I am finished, yes, when he died, the curtain in the temple was torn into two pieces. My God, from the very top to the end, the tear started at the top and tore all the way to the bottom. The earth shook. When Jesus says, I am finished, yes, the earth shook and the rocks were broken, symbolizing that the barrier between God and humanity was removed. I want to let you know, saints of God, in the Old Testament, yes, they had to go to the priest. The priest go to the Lord. Yes, but when Jesus died, yeah, yeah, when that veil, when it tore, we could go boldly to the throne ourselves. You don't have to go am finished. Yeah, yeah. When he died, the graves opened up, and many of God's people who had died were raised from the dead. You are going to re-raise. God told me to tell you. Let me tell you, when Jesus died, when he died on the cross and he rose, when you are baptized, yes, you, when you're baptized in the name of Jesus, when you're buried, hallelujah, you die. God told me to tell you, you live twice and you die once. My God, you live because you're born of a woman. Nicodemus said, how could I be born again? Can I go back into my mother? No. I'm talking about you're born spiritually. My God, you're born when you receive the Holy Ghost, born of the Spirit. So you're born once naturally, born again, yes, oh God, spiritually, and you die once. Because when you die in Christ, you're not, yeah, you can't, you're just in a deep sleep. You're in a deep, deep, deep sleep when you die in Christ Jesus. So I come to tell you, saints of God, hold on to your tests, hold on to your trials, don't throw in the towels. Saints of God, don't throw them in. I come to tell you, you do what you can do. Mary, she couldn't run. She could have hid. She could have stayed home. Mary could have, she couldn't go to the leaders. Now he's innocent. My God, stand to your feet, saints of God. She could have gone to the crowd. Come on, praise team. She could have gone to Pilate. She couldn't go to Pilate. She couldn't go to the Sadducees. She couldn't go to the Pharisees. She couldn't go to them. But she did what she could do. What could she do? She stayed there and watched him until Jesus died. And she was able to see, in the name of Jesus, where they would take his body. Joseph and Nicodemus. Yes, they got permission. Joseph got permission from, yes, Pilate to take his body and wrap it up. And Joseph, there they took him to a tomb that had never been used. And I come to tell you, do what you can do while you're going through your tests. Do what you can do. You can pray about it. Yes, you can touch and agree about it. You can go to God in prayer. Yes, you can get into his word to encourage you. I love to encourage myself by getting into the word of God. Because in the word of God, we got a hiding place from announcement of Jesus' birth. Yeah, to Mary, there was excitement. There was trauma. And then there was victory. Jesus carried the weight of the world. He took the sting out of death. And he promised eternal life. He promised never to leave me. He promised never to forsake me. He promised. He promised. He promised. Yes, one day I'm going where Jesus is. Oh, one day, one day,
one day,
I'm going where Jesus is.
Real soon.
not let you blaspheme. Now that's different. But if you want to be caught up, be caught up. I like that. Caught up. You want to be caught up to meet him.
Caught up to meet him.
The plan of salvation. Repent. Change your way. I want
to
be caught up. Repent. Every last one of you. Repent of your sins. And then when you, God forgives you of your sins, you're saved. But you need to wash your sins away. Be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission. Acts 2:38. Be baptized in his name for the remission and the removal of your sins. And then the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Oh my God, the Holy Ghost. It feels so good. I want to be caught up. Anybody want to be caught up to meet him? Anybody want to be? Anybody? Anybody want confession? Caught up. before I go, let's just give that devil a good slap while we praise God. Ready? Ready? And I want you to pray. We're putting a seal on this with this praise and clapping of our hands. God told me to tell you, all you got to do is believe. And the thing that you want him to do is finished. It's done. It's done. Oh, you just got to believe. So right now, let's just give God, let's seal this message with a hand praise. Ready? One, two, ready, go. Guard and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon and enlighten you and be gracious, kind, merciful, and giving favor to you. The Lord lift up his approving countenance upon you and give you peace, tranquility of heart, and the life continually. May the grace of God be with you all. Have a wonderful Easter celebration. God bless you.